Okay, let's continue understanding tensors. Now, one of the ways we understood vectors was through the idea of a unit vector and a basis. So basically, any time we had a vector A, we could write it as a sum of three independent vectors, which we often made of unit length, and these were called the basis. So these vectors EI were the basis. So the introduction of the concept of a unit vector and a basis greatly helped our understanding of vectors, and we want to do the same for tensors. In order to do that, we have to understand a new operation between vectors. It's called a tensor product, and this is how the notation is. So given any two vectors A and B, I can do the, so far we have been able to do two kinds of operations, a dot product and a cross product. This produced a scalar and this produced a vector. Now we are going to do a new operation which is called the tensor product, which will give a tensor, a second order tensor. Okay, so that's the tensor product. Now how do I understand this operation? Well, as I said before, the only way you understand tensors is by throwing vectors at them, allowing them to operate on vectors and looking at the output. So well, I have my tensor product between two vectors A tensor B. So the way we kind of read it is A tensor B. Okay, and this is how we, so if A tensor B operates on any vector C, this is the output. Okay, so that's one way to understand it. On the other hand, if the vector was operating from the, if the tensor operated from the right, then the output is D. And think about it. If this is my A tensor B, this is my tensor. Okay, so this is my, and if I wanted to define this operation, what is the most logical thing to do? You will agree that the most logical thing to do would be to allow these two to talk. And when you, and what is the most, and the output has to be a vector, right? So what can I do to, how can I define this operation so that the output is a vector and it is very natural? The most natural way to do it would be to allow these two to talk, and the most natural way for them to talk is to do a dot product and this. So this is, I would say this definition is very natural. Similarly, the other one, the one over here, well, if we accept this as being reasonably natural, then this one has to be, it has to be these two talking, and the output is always a vector. Okay, so this is a vector, that is a vector. Okay, so that is how we understand the tensor product of two vectors. Okay, it's just a definition. You don't have to kind of, I mean, you will get more familiar with it as we go along. Okay, so now here are some remarks about it which will kind of make it more familiar to us. This A tensor B goes by many names. So for example, I can also call this, some people call it A dyadic B. Okay, that's another way to call it. Okay, and sometimes it's also called the outer product. Okay. Let's try and do an operation with this. Suppose I have this tensor product, and I also have a coordinate system, my favorite coordinate system. And I know in my coordinate system I can always write this, and similarly I can write B as BJ EJ. Then then A tensor B is obviously AI EI tensor BJ EJ. Well, these two are scalars, so let's pull the scalars out, AI BJ, and what is left is EI tensor EJ. EI tensor EJ. Let's just check whether this satisfies the rules of the index notation. No free indices. I is repeated, it's a dummy index. J is repeated, it's a dummy index. No free index. This is a correct equation. Okay? And this is what it means. So A tensor B is AI BJ EI tensor EJ. Now compare these two. So I'll ask you to compare these kind of formulae. So this is a vector being expressed in terms of its components. And what do we have here? Well, it seems like this dyadic product A tensor B, it can be expressed as the summation over all possible dyadic products of the kind EI tensor EJ, right? I mean, this is what it means, right? What this is A1 B1 E1 tensor E1 plus A1 B2 E1 tensor E2, okay, plus A1 B3 E1 tensor E3, and there will be totally 9 terms, right? Agreed, right? So this A tensor B is expressed as the linear combination, okay, linear combination of all possible EI tensor EJ. All right, now that is very suggestive. Okay, and we'll come back to it shortly. Meanwhile, let us discuss this property. So earlier we had seen that we could take two tensors and they could multiply, okay, they could operate on each other. So what if I have A tensor B, which is a tensor, operating on another tensor? Now we know that this, the top line gave me a tensor which I called D. So the output has to be a tensor. So what is the most natural way to do it? Well, I think the most natural way would be to combine these two as a dot product, okay, just like we had over here, right? And so this should be, so let's combine these two, and that will give me B dot C, that's a scalar, and what is left is A and D. Well, what is left is A and D, and the output has to be a tensor, so the most natural thing between them would be A tensor D, okay, and that's what is written over here. A tensor B operate multiplying the tensor C tensor D, and B and C contract, or you take the dot product between them, and you get A tensor D, okay. All right, so now coming back to trying to find a basis, a basis for a tensor. So we'll come back to this idea over here. So here we had that we could take any tensor, tensor product between vectors, and express this as a linear combination of all possible EI tensor EJ. So if you compare this and this for vectors with this expression for tensors, I think you will be inclined to call EI tensor EJ as a tensorial basis. Well, to begin with, any tensor product of two vectors can be expressed as a linear combination of EI tensor EJ. All right, so this is a tensorial basis, and we can count, well, how many can I take? I can be 1 to 3, J can go from 1 to 3. So basically there are 9 such unit tensors, and they form the basis. Okay, so what's the use of this basis? Well, the use is very similar to vectors. In the case of vectors, we could always write A as EI, EI. So what can I do with a tensor? Suppose I have a tensor A and I am working in my favorite coordinate system, this one. That's my favorite coordinate system. So let's imagine that we can write A as a linear combination over the basis. So my basis, remember, was EI tensor EJ. So that's EI tensor EJ. And a linear combination is this. Let's make sure it is true. No free index, no free index. I is a dummy index, J is a dummy index, and we are summing over I and summing over J, and this will be a linear combination of the kind A11 E1 tensor E1 plus A12 E1 tensor E2 plus so on plus A33 E3 tensor E3, and these will be 9 terms. Okay. So let's imagine we can write a tensor like this in terms of this tensorial basis. So the question becomes, well, when I had this, I could extract from it AI as A dot EI. How do I extract AIJ? Well, actually, it's not that hard. All you need to do is you need to kind of imitate what you did over here. And the imitation is this formula. Aij is ei dot a dot ej. That's the formula. You don't believe me? Let's try it out. We are writing A as Aij, Ei tensor Ej. Well, we already have Ij's over here, so let's write A as AKL Ek tensor EL, right? And we will take this formula and put it in there and see what we get. Run out of page, so let me actually copy all this stuff to the next page. Okay, so here's what we were doing. We want to find Aij. A is giving like this, and I am claiming that's the formula. Okay, let's try it. Now, the first thing that you should ask is, which should I do this first or should I do that first? And you can check, it actually doesn't matter. You can do the left operation first or the right operation first, the answer is the same, and that is why I don't put any brackets over here. Okay, all right, so let's compute this. So I get, so I'm computing this over here, EI dot, okay, dot AKL EK tensor EL dot EJ. All right, well, as I said, you could do this operation first or you could do that one first. It really doesn't matter. Either way, you will get AKL is a constant. That is a constant, so it comes over here. When you do these two, you will get delta IK. When you do these two, you will get delta LJ. And well, now you can contract I and K, so this one's, you know, by contraction, this becomes AI. Let's indicate this K, IK, and the other one, L, LJ, that'll give me AIJ, and which is what I wanted to prove. So indeed, Aij, the kind of the components of A in this coordinate system is given by that formula. Okay, so that's how we understand a tensor. Let's go through that again. We wanted to extend the concept of a unit vector and basis to tensors. We developed the idea of a tensor product between two vectors. which had these properties. And then we realized that this A tensor B can be expanded as a linear summation over quantities of the kind EI tensor EJ. We claimed EI tensor EJ to be a tensorial basis, and there are 9 such unit tensors. They form a basis, and now any tensor can be expressed in terms of its components Aij summed over all possible 9 unit tensors, where Aij are then called the components of A in this coordinate system. Okay, moving on.